إن الحمد لله، نحمده سبحانه وتعالى ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه، ونعوذ بالله سبحانه وتعالى من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهدي الله فلا مضل له، ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، والذي خلق السماوات والأرض في ستة أيام ثم استوى على العرش، يعلم ما يلج في الأرض وما يخرج منها وما ينزل من السماء وما يعرج فيها، وهو معكم أينما كنتم، والله بما تعملون بصير. هو الذي خلق فسوى، والذي قدر فهدى، وهو سبحانه وتعالى الذي أخرج المرعى فجعله غثاء أحوى. ونشهد أن سيدنا محمدًا عبده ورسوله، وصفيه من خلقه وحبيبه، بلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة ونصح الأمة وكشف الغمة وتركها على المحجة البيضاء، ليلها كنهارها لا يزيغ عنها إلا هالك. فصلوات ربي وسلامه عليه وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. يقول المولى عز وجل في كتابه العظيم بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم: يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. أما بعد، my dear brothers and sisters in Islam، إن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله، وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار، نعوذ بالله سبحانه وتعالى من النار. My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, we are in the best day that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make it Eid for all of us. It's a big holiday, which is Friday. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make these days one of the best days of the month. And He gave the whole surah, Surah Al-Quran, Surah Al-Jum'ah, إذا نودي للصلاة من يوم الجمعة فاسعوا إلى ذكر الله وذروا البيع. If the call comes for the Friday prayer, leave everything behind you and run to offer your prayer. This is gift from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When we talk about Friday, we talk about coming Friday. We don't forget. It's going to be يوم عاشوراء. And what is the importance of this day for us? If we are studying the seerah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and Al al-Bayt and the family of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and the prophets, you're going to see this day, it's meaning a lot for the ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, because as a Muslims, we believe in all the prophets. We believe in all of them. آمن الرسول بما أنزل إليه من ربه والمؤمنون كل آمن بالله وملائكته وكتبه ورسله. We believe in all the prophets, all the books. We are lucky. We're not only taking one part. We believe in all the prophets. Then we need to talk about the importance of Ashura for all of us. While the young people here, most of them didn't know about Ashura. But it's important from the parents to discuss the seerah of Ashura with their kids. So they should understand what is Ashura. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as we are on Friday, He created the earth and the sky on Friday. He created Adam on Friday. And he died on Friday. End of the dunya will be on Friday. Imagine if today is the last day of the whole entire life, which is not, because we have our characters and the sign of the hours, and the people did not come to pray. Imagine if the hour come and we're still alive or not, and the people who pray, and the hour is coming, and the last thing they did in their life is a prayer. Is this Friday important or not? Think about it. It's a gift from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for the ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he got hurt a lot from the people of Mecca. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala asked him to leave Mecca with your people, ya Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Over there you're going to have a better opportunity to carry the da'wah, the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The plan started from Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The topic is so huge, but I'm going to try, inshallah, finish in time. He had a plan to leave his place empty. But Sayyidina Ali ibn Abi Talib radiallahu anhu arda, as a young man, he insists to be in the bed to cover so the people can see the Prophet is still there. While he left sallallahu alayhi wa sallam with all his companions, after he discussed the plan with Sayyidina Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu anhu arda. So the plan, you have to leave and no one can notice that. So they have a plan, and it's so beautiful story to understand it, how the security level is when he's moving from one place to another place with all the security around him and behind him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, until they reach the Ghar Hiraq, and the story is too long. And Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu anhu arda, said, Ya Rasulullah, if they look under, they will see us. They say, what do you think about two and Allah the third? What do you think about the power of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Remember these words, because this word is coming up with Musa alayhi salam. And he went to Al-Madinah al-Munawwara. Al-Madinah al-Munawwara was the place that the Islam started strongly, with the most of the Quran revealed to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And he completed the Quran in the last khutbah of khutbah al-wada'a, when he said, Al-Yawma akmaltu lakum deenakum. وَرَدِيتُ لَكُمْ الْإِسْلَامَ دِينًا. The Islam is your deen. Today is the day that he completed the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Today we are Muslims, alhamdulillah. You look around you, the mushaf everywhere. It's in your phone. It's in your house. It's in your car. Definitely we carry that. But this is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, إِنَّا أَنْذَحْنُ أَنَزَّلْنَا الذِّكْرَ وَإِنَّا لَهُ لَحَافِظُونَ. We revealed the dhikr, the Quran, and we are saving that. When what happened over there, and the person burned the Quran, and a thousand of people went there, carried the mushaf, and you are against that. Of course we are against that. But when you carry the mushaf, and thousands of people is there, every one of them, and us, asked ourselves, and they asked themselves, where they are from the prayer time, for where they are from the masajid. If we have this number and all the masajid, we will be the strong community, strong Muslims. Not to stand off the street to show up the people, we are Muslim, you don't burn the Quran. Look at yourself, what did you do with your Quran? What did you memorize? Did you recite the Quran? I'm struggling. You get the double reward. That's what Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said. But when he reached Al-Madina sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he built the iman inside the companions. And because of them, we are here today. When he reached Al-Madina, he found the Jewish people fasting. And he asked them, why you are fasting today? They say, this is the day Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saved Musa alayhi salam from Fir'aun. And we are fasting to thanks Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Stop right here. Because fasting, because thanking, because obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Thanks Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by fasting. So if Allah seems to give you something really good, you can fast, say, for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I'm happy he gave me that. But we do that only if someone of us lost one of the relatives, we come to the masjid and we pray and we cry. We lost this person. But see, the fasting and the prayers of the part of thankful Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for what he did. And he said, لَوْ أَحْيَانِ اللَّهِ لَأُسُمَنَّ التَّاسَ وَالْعَاشَرَ. Because the companion said, Ya Rasulullah, are we going to copy them and do fast the same day? He said, well, if Allah give me time, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala take his soul earlier than that. لَأُسُمَنَّ التَّاسَ وَالْعَاشَرَ. Coming Friday is Ashura. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, if you fast the day of Ashura, all the best bad deed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive. You come new again with no bad deeds. But the majority of ulama, they said fasting Friday by itself, makruh. You can fast, but it's not correct. It's not right. Either you fast Thursday or Friday and Saturday. This is opportunity from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I give it to you as a gift. So you don't miss it. But Musa alayhi salam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tested him while he's facing Fir'aun, the power man, the strong man, the best army in the world at this time. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala let Fir'aun in his dream saw someone from Bani Israel will take over his place. Then he said, kill all the boys. But they said to Fir'aun, but we need them because they are servants. They help us. Say, okay, 1 year you kill the boys, 1 year you leave them. The year that Harun burned was a safe year. So Harun was saved. But it came time of Musa alayhi salam. So his mother, she was worried and she was crying. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave her the order. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave the order for the people who he loved, the people who got connected with him. Link it with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He told her, just put him in the tabut, in the box, and throw him in the yam, throw him in the water. يَأْخُذُوا عَدُوٌ لِي وَعَدُوٌ لَهُ. The enemy will take him. And over there, he's gonna grow up. But حَرَّمْنَا عَلَيْهِ الْمَوَضَعِ. He's not gonna get the breastfeed from no one. استمشي أختك فتقول هل أدلكم على من يكفله فرددناك إلى أمك كي تقر عينها ولا تحزن. We let your sister follow up, and she said, yeah, it's not easy, but I know someone can take care of him. So return him back to his mother كي تقر عينها ولا تحزن, to stop crying, don't get sad. This is the mercy and love from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Musa alayhi salam grew up as a man, but he was tested a lot from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He was scared from Fir'aun. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said to him, go to Fir'aun, fight with him. Tell him the deen of Allah. If he's not, stay firm in front of him. Say, oh Allah, how? اذهب إلى فرعون إنه طغى. Go to Fir'aun. He thinks he's the Lord. قال أنا ربكم الأعلى. I am your Lord. But he asked Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by someone supporting him. هارون أخي, my brother هارون, أشدد به أذري وأشركه في أمري كي نسبحك كثيرا ونذكرك كثيرا إنك كنت بنا بصيرا. We need you, ya Allah, to give me my brother, which is today brothers not talking to each others. Today we have these issues. Look at Musa alayhi salam, he's asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for his brother. Harun akhi, a strong word. You live with your brother and with your sister more than 20 years until you get married. By the time you get married, and then the boys will start, and your wife or the husband of the wife will say something wrong about your brother and sister. You cut the relation because someone new come in your life to stop your relation with your brother and your sister and your father and your mother. That's how we are. هارون أخي. That's Musa alayhi salam. But when he stand in front of Fir'aun, and Fir'aun, he said, who's your Lord? He said, Rabbi wa Rabbak, my Lord, my Rabb and your Rabb. Then he didn't believe in that. And they say, Musa came with a magic. He's a majesty. I don't need him. Bring all my people. Look what he's doing. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say, ya Musa, don't be afraid. وما تلك بيمينك يا موسى قال هي عصاي اتوكا عليها واوش بها على غنمي ولي فيها مارب اخرى قال القها يا موسى فالقاها فاذا هي حيه تسعى قال خذها ولا تخف سنعيدها سيرتها الاولى واضمم يدك الى جناحك تخرج بيضاء من غير سوء ايه اخرى او موسى don't be afraid. The stick you have in your hand is a good word between موسى and Allah سبحانه وتعالى. Beautiful dialogue. What's in your hand, ya Musa? He says, my stick. I just for my sheep and all of that, and I walk in the street with. He said, throw it. It's going to be alive. It can eat everything that you throw it. The Sahara of Fir'aun, don't worry about it. So the Sahara, when they saw what Musa is doing it, you get scared. You say, this is not a magic. No. It's something more stronger than that. This is a Lord of Musa alayhi salam and Harun. And you all became a Muslim. Muslim is Western, Jewish. The Islam is the deen of every single person on the earth. They became on the side of Musa. While Fir'aun, he said, you go with him. You believe in the Lord without my permission. Who you are to give the permission for us? You want to do something, do it. Say, I'm going to kill you. I'm going to cut your hand and your leg. Do it. But who believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Rabbu Musa.
And the message came to Musa alayhi salam to run away with his people, because Pharaoh now he prepared the whole troops to get rid of him. And this is the day when he walked with his troop, with his people, Musa alayhi salam, to leave the country. And then the message came from his people, we are in trouble. They're gonna get us. We're gonna get killed. And Musa alayhi salam قال إني معي ربي, Allah is me, don't worry. He threw the stick in the water, it became solid. So they pass and get saved. This is the day of Ashura. This is the day of Ashura. So remember, the story is too long. I need you to go and share it with your kids. Read. It's easy and simple. But the day of Ashura, with another big story, sad story. When Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam died, the Khilafah is Shura. Together, who will be the leader? Not like today, the king, and they give it to his son, and son give it to the son, and you see all this corrupted. And Abu Bakr took over. After Abu Bakr, Umar. After Umar, Sayyidina Uthman. After Uthman, Sayyidina Ali ibn Abi Talib. And then first thing he did, Ali ibn Abi Talib, he said to Muawiyah, you stay away, because you're not fair enough with the people. Muawiyah rejected. They start as his troop against Sayyidina Ali ibn Abi Talib. Fighting ended by discussion, stop, everybody be alone, and that's it. But in behind, he hired people to kill Sayyidina Ali ibn Abi Talib. Ali ibn Abi Talib got killed in the Fajr. Muawiyah became more strong, people get scared. After Sayyidina Ali ibn Abi Talib, Sayyidina al-Hasan. Al-Hasan ibn Ali, he saw the problem getting bigger and bigger. So he decided to leave it for Muawiyah to stop and save the blood, because we are in the Shahr al-Hurum. Hurum months, forbidden months. But somehow the Ghadr, and they came behind and they put poison in his food and he got died. And the people started talking, Sayyidina al-Husayn ibn Ali radiallahu anhu ardah, you have to go and save us from Muawiyah and his people. We all surrounded you, we all helping you, we are supporting you. Sayyidina al-Husayn, he decided to go to Karbala, to Al-Iraq with his people. He took all his family with him, the whole family. And he went there with the permission for a Muslim that everybody is waiting to help him and support him. But when he reached there, he find different story. People get scared and they run away. Only Sayyidina al-Husayn and his family. But he refused to come back. But Muawiyah, he let his son Yazid took over. Yazid, when he took over, he hired the best army person at his time, Ziyad. So he said to Ziyad, you taking care of Al-Husayn, I need him. So Ziyad was a terrible person. But Yazid was one of the leaders, he was drunk all the time. Give up the prayers. Against the Islam. So Ziyad, when the war starts, first of all, they surrounded Sayyidina al-Husayn and his people together. They surrounded all of them. So there's no more food, no more water. But he has his kids with him. They ask for water. Father has no power, no water at all. No water with him, and the people die from no water. The war starts. When the war starts, they kill most of the men from Sayyidina al-Husayn radiallahu anhu arda. But the people of Ziyad, they went inside because they have no power, no water, no food. They're getting very weak. They get Sayyidina al-Husayn and they start slaughter his head, just to separate the head from his body. Front of his sister, Zainab. Zainab bint Fatima al-Zahra bint Rasulillah bint Sayyidina Ali ibn Abi Talib radiyallahu anhu arda. She saw her brother when they slaughtered and separated his head from his body. And they took all the ladies to Ziyad. And the front, the head of Sayyidina al-Husayn radiallahu anhu warda. Imagine that. Things happen like that in front of any one of your family. Wallahi, during the Qurbani time, if you look at the animal eyes before you slaughter them, you will never do it. Wallahi, you will never do it if you see any animal's eyes in front of you and you try to slaughter it. Because of that, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, mercy and kind, but just let it down. Because it's hard. Imagine a human being, what kind of heart he got to cut the head of Sayyidina al-Husayn, the grandson of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allah described them in the Holy Quran about their hearts, كَالْحِجَارَ أَوْ أَشَدَّ قَصْوَةً, more than the stone. How they firm, they have no hearts. Not only that, he gave the order for the soldier to go over with the horses and the body of Sayyidina al-Husayni back and forth. Imagine the whole scenario. No humanity. They don't have Islam. And that's happened in the Yawm of Ashura. And today you see the Shia, they cut themselves and the blood coming from them. They kill al-Husayn and now they cry for al-Husayn. This is the day of Ashura, the day we are celebrating, the day that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saved Musa, and this is the same day the soul of Sayyidina al-Husayn went away. By shukrillah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, thank me if you have something good or something bad. So we're fasting, because this is a good day Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive our sins. أَقُولُ قَوْلِ هَذَا وَاسْتَغْفِرُ اللَّهِ لِي وَلَكُمْ لِسَائِرِ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه ومن والاه. So my dear brothers and sisters in Islam, from the seerah of Sayyidina Musa alayhi salam and the story of Ali ibn Abi Talib and his family, Al-Husayn wal-Hasan, the two grandchild of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, it's a lot of stories. From there, we ask ourselves, what did we do for our Islam? Take it individual, and I have to take it individual. What did we do for the Islam? How we are practicing our Islam? How we are facing our Islam? Today, alhamdulillah, anywhere you go, Muslim and non-Muslim, they say, Assalamu alaikum. From where they learn it? By being working together. By being helping each other. Do you know you are Muslim? Do you know you have Friday prayer? They let me and the others go and pray. They give us permission because they know this is our deen. But if you are afraid to say Assalamu alaikum, you are afraid to take a few hours off from your, to go for your prayer on Friday, it's you. It's not Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us so many days to forgive us. He gave us Arafat, the days of Ramadan. They give us the Ashura. They give us a lot of days. He like you to continue the Iman and the belief. The masajid in the Fajr time and Isha time is empty. And when we have some issue, we are in strike together, gathering. We are Muslims. How you practice your Islam? Did you discuss the Islam with your child? Or you let them grow? What do you have in your hand? The Facebook and the phone. Everything in the phone. They don't even have time to talk to you. Brothers and sisters, maybe I'm wrong. Go to any mall. And brother like my age, remember before years, before we have the Facebook or whatever, when we go to the mall, we keep rush our spouse. Hey, hurry up, hurry up. You took too long. Today, go to any mall and see. If the wife shopping or the husband shopping, no interruption. Every one of them in the Facebook. They don't care about the time or the hour. They don't care like before. Before they are in rush because nothing can support them, nothing can take their minds away. Today, we don't remember any phone numbers. Before, we remember all the phone numbers, 1, 2, 3. Today, let me go for the contact and say, find it. 1 second, brother, 1 second, sister, I will find it for you. What is it? We lost our brain because we lost memorization of our book, the Quran. If you memorize in the Quran, you memorize the whole book. Medical, engineer, any college, accountant, if you cannot touch your Quran, you're not going to be successful in your life. Study books to pass the exam. But when it comes to one book, we're not alert. Only we're upset if somebody burned the Quran. We are upset. A beautiful sign, I repeat it everywhere I go now. It's in the masjids. And they said, the kids in the masjids being kicked out because they are noisy and they make a trouble in the masjid. We do. And the bottom, the same kids, when they grow, you will fight with them so they can come to the masjid and pray. If you are mercy and kind for them when they are young, let them pray. Let them play. Fine, enjoy it. It's the same people, the same kids will love the masjid. But if you kick them out, following, you force them to come, they don't like to come and pray. They don't. And we see them in the masjid everywhere we go. A beautiful kids, they memorizing Quran. When they start to lead the prayer sometime, and they are mature, and all the people come and they grab them, we need someone here with a long beard to come and lead the prayer. From where we get that? And same kids, when I saw them and I speak to them, why don't go inside the masjid? No, I wait until they come and then I go inside because I don't like trouble. Who did that? We. Because we are jahil. We don't understand our deen. We don't support them. Sayyidina Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when he is going down for the sujood, Al-Hasan wal-Husayn, they lay on the top of his shoulder. He extend all his sujood time so he never interrupted them while they play, not to kick them out of the masjid. So my dear brothers and sisters in Islam, we are in the beautiful month of Muharram. Al-Muharram, one of the forbidden months. And they imagine you get Friday in the same month. Kindly, I remind you again, if you are fasting Friday and Saturday or Thursday and Friday, makruh, unacceptable, Friday only. That's by majority of the ulama and Ibn Uthaymeen. I'm not coming from myself and say that. It's by all the scholars. So please, I see all the masajid, alhamdulillah, they have iftar this day. Majority of the masajid, alhamdulillah, it's time for gathering together to discuss the seerah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam and Musa alayhi salam, and see what happened to Sayyidina al-Husayn, how he's very strong, and he go and fight, and he lost his life because of the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And when we have something Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala supporting us, you have to fast and make prayer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala spoke to Musa alayhi salam, إني أنا ربك فخلع عليك إنك بالوادي المقدس طوى وأنا اخترتك فاستمع لما يوحى إنني أنا الله لا إله إلا أنا فاعبدني وأقم الصلاة لذكري إن الساعة آتية لا ريب فيها. Believe in Allah, Salah, and the hour is coming. The hour is coming, no matter what. No one of us will remain in this dunya, we're gonna die. Definitely we're gonna leave. So work for these hours. And the hour would be Friday. Ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make all the Fridays the best Fridays in our life. Ask Him subhanahu wa ta'ala أن يغفر لنا الذنوب وأن يكفر عنا السيئات. اللهم اشف مرضانا ومرضى المسلمين وارحم أمواتهم وأموات المسلمين. اللهم لا تجعل لنا ذنبا إلا غفرته ولا مريضا إلا شفيته ولا ميتا إلا رحمته. اللهم اغفر لوالدينا وارحمهما كما ربيانا صغارا. اللهم اغفر لوالدينا وارحمهما كما ربيانا صغارا. اللهم ابعد الشيطان عن بيوتنا وعن أبنائنا وأمهاتنا وأهلينا يا كريم. اللهم اجعلنا من عبادك المغفورين في جناتك مقبولين. اللهم حرم النار على أجسادنا وأجساد آبائنا وأمهاتنا وأهلينا يا كريم. اللهم اجمعنا مع أهلينا في عليين مع الحبيب المصطفى صلى الله عليه وسلم. اللهم أرنا آباءنا في جناتك جنات النعيم وأنبياءك الأكرام المحبوبين. اللهم يا رحمن يا رحيم نستغفرك ونتوب إليك ونعوذ بك من كل شر. لا إله إلا أنت سبحانك إني كنت من الظالمين. وصلى اللهم على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. عباد الله رحمني ورحمكم الله، إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. واذكروا الله العلي العظيم يذكركم وادعوه يستجب لكم وأقم الصلاة.